Hello friends, please like, subscribe, share and comment. It will motivate us to carry on this project for the welfare of students preparing to get government job through Shorthand. Thank you for watching. Ready, start. It must be restricted to cases of grave dereliction of duty and flagrant abuse of fundamental principle of law or justice, where grave injustice would be done unless the High Court interferes. Unless there was any grave miscarriage of justice or flagrant violation of law calling for intervention, it is not for the High Court under Articles 2 to 6 and 2 to 7 of the Constitution to interfere. A Constitution bench of Apex Court examined the scope of Article 2 to 7 of the Constitution in Varyam Singh and another versus Amarnath and another AIR 1954 SC 215 and made following observations at page 571. This power of superintendence conferred by Article 2 to 7 is as pointed out by Harris CJ in Dalmia Jain Airways Limited versus Sukumar Mukherjee AIR 1951 Calcutta 193 to be exercised most sparingly and only in appropriate cases in order to keep the subordinate courts within the bounds of their authority and not for correcting mere errors. In the case of Muhammad Yunus versus Muhammad Mustaqim and others AIR 1984 SC 38, the court held that this court has very limited scope under Article 2 to 7 of the Constitution and even the errors of law cannot be corrected in exercise of power of judicial review under Article 2 to 7 of the Constitution. The power can be used sparingly when it comes to the conclusion that the authority oblique tribunal has exceeded its jurisdiction or proceeded under erroneous presumption of jurisdiction. The High Court cannot assume unlimited prerogative to correct all species of hardship or wrong decision. For interference, there must be a case of flagrant abuse of fundamental principles of law or where order of the tribunal, etc., has resulted in grave injustice. For interference under Article 2 to 7, the finding of facts recorded by the authority should be found to be perverse or patently erroneous and dehorse the factual and legal position on record. It is well settled that power under Article 2 to 7 is of the judicial superintendence which cannot be used to upset conclusions of facts, howsoever erroneous those may be, unless such conclusions are so perverse or so unreasonable that no court could ever have reached them. Power under Article 2 to 7 of the Constitution is not in the nature of power of appellate authority enabling reappreciation of evidence. It should not alter the conclusion reached by the competent statutory authority merely on the ground of insufficiency of evidence. In Ajayab Singh versus Sarhind Cooperative Marketing Cum Processing Service Society Limited 1999 6 SEC 82, the court has held that there is no justification for the High Court to substitute its view for the opinion of the authorities oblique courts below, as the same is not permissible in proceedings under Articles 2 to 6 oblique 2 to 7 of the Constitution. In Mohan Amba Prasad Agnihotri versus Bhaskar Balwant Ahir AIR 2000 SC 931, the court said that jurisdiction of High Court under Article 2 to 7 of the Constitution is not appealable but supervisory. Therefore, it cannot interfere with the findings of fact recorded by High Courts below unless there is no evidence to support findings or the findings are totally perverse. In Indian Overseas Bank versus Indian Overseas Bank Staff Canteen Workers Union 2004 SEC 245, the court observed that it is impermissible for the writ court to reappreciate evidence liberally and drawing conclusions on its own on pure questions of fact for the reason that it is not exercising appellate jurisdiction over the awards passed by a tribunal. The findings of fact recorded by the fact-finding authority duly constituted for the purpose ordinarily should be considered to have become final. The same cannot be disturbed for the mere reason of having based on materials or evidence not sufficient or credible in the opinion of writ court to warrant those findings. Stop.